Hello everyone, my name is Shivam and today we are going to study stored procedure in SQL. At the end of the lecture, I will also give the notes so everyone can review, and if any doubts, please comment and yeah, I will be happy to answer the questions. So what is stored procedure? So if you look at the definition, right, stored procedure is a prepared SQL code that you can save so that the code can be reused over and over again. So stored procedure is just like a SQL query, and the feature of this stored procedure is that we can reuse it over and over again, and it facilitates code reusability in our program. So let's see by looking at the practical example. So I have this employees table. I'm selecting everything from the employees and we will get the table like this. This is my entire record. It has 7 rows in it. Let's create a procedure. So I'm creating a procedure to get all the employees. So the syntax for creating a procedure is like this: create procedure, then procedure name. So I like to have prefix as SP, which means stored procedure, and then write my stored procedure name, because this section will contain the name of the procedure. So SP means it's a stored procedure, so everyone will know that, yeah, it is a stored procedure. So I'm writing SP get all employees, and then I'm writing as begin end. So what does this as begin end means? So this procedure will be as like what we gonna define in begin and end. So this is the starting of the procedure. This will where the end will be. So I'm copy pasting this, select everything from the employee and pasting here. So this procedure is now defined by the single line of code selecting everything from the employee, and let's create this procedure to see if it is get created, and it's get created successfully. And yeah, now how to execute this procedure, right? We have created the procedure. Now how to execute? So for executing, we just have to copy this, paste it in the new line, and select this and execute. That's it. So now we got everything from the employee. Suppose we want to create a procedure that will have a filter of age, let's say. So I'm gonna create another stored procedure here, and SP get employees by age I'm writing. I've copy pasted the above procedure, and I'm writing where age is greater than, let's say, 25. So above 25 we have Chris and Sarah. Okay, so let me run this procedure, get completed successfully. Now how to execute? Copy this, paste it down below, and just execute this. That's it, done. So 28 28, Chris and Sarah has been displayed. The procedure is working fine. Now this was procedure without parameters, right? So with this we know that procedure is the simple SQL query which can be reused anywhere in our code, right? But now how to pass parameter? Like I want to decide what age filter I want to put. Okay, so I am copying this stored procedure again, and now SP get all employees by age, but now the filter will be from the user. Okay, and the way to do pass the parameter in a procedure, like we pass parameter in a function, we just have to make a bracket like we do in function, and type, let's say if I want to provide parameter as age, so I will type age with the @, and what is the data type for the age, what is the type of age? Basically it's an integer, right? So I will write integer, correct? So like function, only thing it is reverse. So first we have @age and then integer, and here I will put @age. Okay, so what this mean, let me give me 1 second, I'll explain everything. So I'm writing it here, and let's say 25 again. Okay, So here, when I write this SP get employees, and when I'm writing with a space and writing 25, this 25 will go in this age and select everything from the employees where age is greater than 25, right? So it will display the same thing, 28, 28, right? If I want to display 22, now the age will be 22 and it will display ages which is greater than 22. So the value of this at the rate age will be 22. You can write here at the rate age 1, whatever you want to feel like, you can write anything, right? So it depends on us what we want to declare here, right? Let me do it. I have also put another name just to avoid some confusions, and let me execute this. It got completed successfully. I am requesting this, executing this, and you will see age 2028. Let me put, let's say, age greater than 18. Executing it again. See, you got this. So the thing is, with store procedure, you can reuse this thing again and again. Let's say if I put 9. So again, the same thing will gonna happen. Entire row will be displayed. Okay. Now this was with one parameter. How to pass multiple parameters in a store procedure? So if we see all this parameter, then we have covered all the store procedure scenarios. So I'm gonna let's say I want to insert a row in this employees table. So what I'm going to do? Create procedure. Again, create procedure, then procedure name with SP, insert employee. Okay, and as begin end. In begin and end, you will write what you want to do. Okay, now I want to insert something, right? In the employee table, it expects ID, name, age, salary. So parameters will be at the rate ID, which is of int. At the rate name, which is varchar, varchar 50, let's say, because name is 50 varchar when I created the table. Let me separate it with commas. And age is there, age of type int. Okay, then we have salary of type int. That's it. The only thing we have to make show that data type come after, and here at the rate. That's it. Great. Now in the begin, I'll just write insert into employees, my table name, values, at the rate ID, comma, at the rate name, comma, at the rate age, comma, at the rate salary. That's it. Great. Now, when we create this procedure, let me see it once again and everything looks good. Let me execute this procedure. It got executed perfectly. Now, when it comes to passing the parameters, we just have to call this insert employee procedure, and then we can pass the parameters like this with a space. ID, let's say 8. Name, let's say I want to write Kate. Then age, let's say 29. Salary, let's say 3500. Let me select this and execute it. You will see the one row affected. That means it has been inserted. And for that, I can run this procedure SP get all employees. I don't have to run this because this procedure is there. Okay. And now you will see Kate is also there. Okay. So these are the all the things we have in store procedure. First, without parameters, we have discussed with filter and without filter. The third thing is by passing the parameter single, and the last one is passing multiple parameters. I will also paste down the notes below in the comments, so you can refer to that, and if any question, please do ask. If you want SQL course video, so please also comment it down, and have a great day. Bye. Thank you so much.